In this work, we have explored learning-based strategies for regression testing in continuous integration settings. In continuous integration, developers frequently commit changes. These changes are then integrated in the code base by continuous build and test cycles. A problem that they often face is that the time to run regression tests is often less than the time available between two consecutive commits. So they need to decide which tests to run or which tests to run first. This is the test selection and test prioritization problems. In this work, we focus on the test prioritization problem, learning-based prioritization, but we also use a common conventional test selection technique in order to give the prioritization algorithms a subset of tests to prioritize at each cycle, at each continuous integration cycle. So the process foresees that at each commit, the test selection process updates the dependency graph based on the code that has been committed. And from this graph, we infer the changed classes and the depending test targets. The output is the set of tests that need to be prioritized in that cycle. So to run machine learning-based prioritization algorithms, we characterize the tests with a set of features. These features are code change metrics extracted from the code repository and test metrics, so metrics that represent the history of the tests in the past cycles. These are given to the prioritization algorithms, and the output is the ranked test list to execute in that specific cycle. These are executed, and the output is used to update the test history for the next cycle. The algorithm that we compare, the prioritization algorithms that we compare, are listed in these tables. They are 10 algorithms, 7 are LTR learning to rank algorithms, and 3 are reinforcement learning algorithms. 9 of these algorithms will never be applied to continuous integration. These are quite representative of learning to rank algorithms because they include both pointwise, pairwise, and listwise algorithms, and they include also ensemble and non-ensemble learning. The test prioritization criteria that we use are fault detection and execution time, test execution time. So the output is the ranked test list, which is expected to detect more fault and to have shorter test execution times. The research questions that we target are these three. How do the selected algorithms perform? What is the influence of the code under test? What is the influence of the continuous integration process characteristics? Specifically, the algorithms are tested on Apache Commons or libraries, and the main metrics that we adopt are the rank percentile average, which tells how much a predicted ranking is close to the actual ranking, and it's our effectiveness metrics. Our cost metrics is the time for prioritization, which includes both the training time and the ranking time, so the prioritization time of the algorithms. Results in a nutshell. In terms of training time, what we observed is that besides the specific differences between each algorithm, is that the reinforcement learning takes much longer because it's an online training. Training is repeated at each cycle. On the other hand, reinforcement learning can run test cases since the beginning because it does not need to wait for a long training process before starting the prioritization task. So it can be used when we need to run tests at the first cycle. In terms of performance, effectiveness, and efficiency metrics, pairwise LTR and ensemble methods are best RPA and good ranking times, and they also have good training times. Reinforcement learning has high ranking times too, besides high training times, and have poorer RPA, except reinforcement learning with the random forest, which performs a little bit better. The other extreme is listwise LTR, which has worse RPA and best ranking times, which can be useful in some contexts. In terms of the impact of the code under test, we investigated the impact of the code variability and show that All RTR approaches are more affected by code variability, while reinforcement learning algorithms, which performs poorer, are more robust to variations of the code, because they are online learning algorithms. So it, they can be used for when the code is subject to high variability. In terms of failure proneness, non-ensemble algorithms, which also perform poorer, in as we have seen in RQ1, are less sensitive to the number of failing tests. So they perform acceptably both under balanced dataset and under unbalanced datasets. In terms of impact of the process, we have investigated the algorithms under constrained scenarios in which the intercommit time was not enough to run all 100% of selected tests, but just a percentage of these tests. We show that results under this constrained scenario are not always in line with non-constrained ones. This means that under constrained scenarios, one can prefer an algorithm that performs bad under unconstrained scenarios, but performs well with constrained ones. In terms of impact of the length of the history available for training, we show that while RPA is quite insensitive, the training time increases a lot with the sample size, especially for reinforcement learning-based algorithms. But the outcome, the other side of the coin, is that above a threshold, increasing the sample size does not improve effectiveness. So it's basically useless. So beside the specific results obtained for the algorithms that we have tested, the key message is that when we are going to design a learning-based strategy for prioritization in continuous integration, we should not just focus on performance under the nominal scenario, but we have to take into account multiple criteria, because these criteria better characterize the technique and better characterize the context in which the technique is applied. Both the code under test and the process, the continuous integration process. We have identified a list of these requirements that we have investigated in the previous research question. It's a not exhaustive list, but we believe it's a good starting point for researchers and practitioners that want to design or select a learning-based strategies for their prioritization task in continuous integration. Thank you for your attention.